Hello everyone. In this video I'm going to start on a new freeform geode, and this time I'm going to do it on an acetate sheet. And someone in my other videos suggested that I should use this because it was also heat resistant, and her name is Jacqueline Lopez. And I want to thank her very much for her suggestion, because I think it's a good idea to use this kind of plastic. It's a thicker plastic. And what I'm curious about is when I take the geode out of the mold, that I have a shiny back and I don't have any wrinkles. That's what I'm testing here. Because it's heat resistant, what I already said, so I can use some heat already in the first layer. So there are two things I'm gonna test, and so you can see I have two sheets taped together, because I could get sheets that were 60 by 40 centimeters, but I wanted it a little bit larger. So I already know that I have a rim when I take the geode out of the mold. But that doesn't matter for me, because I want to make a table of it, just as I want to do with the other two geodes I made. And I already ordered some table legs, and when I attach them to the geode, I also make a video of that, so you can see how I do that. But this geode is gonna be rather large. I already started with silicon. I'm using 100% clear tube silicon. And yeah, another shape than I already did. And I'm laying down now the first line. And then I let it dry and put the second line on it. But I have good hopes that this kind of plastic works. And I also want to say that someone asked me if I want to check out the Duralar film. And her name is Laura Taylor. I don't know if you watched this video, Laura Taylor, but I checked it out, and I think it's almost the same as I use now. And that Duralar film is also heat resistant, and I think it would work. If this works, then what you suggested also works. So that's my answer to you, Laura Taylor. So almost done with the first line. And this geode is going to be totally different in color. I'm not going to tell you what colors I'm going to use, but it are colors that I normally wouldn't use. But yeah, I like to think out of the box, so yeah, something totally different. Yeah, I'm using my stick to make the line a little bit smoother. So we are a little bit further in the process. I already did a second line on top of the first, and I did a line on the outside of the outer barrier and on the inside of the inner barriers, to make sure that it doesn't leak, because my last geode, if you looked at that video, my silicon barrier leaked in some places. So now I'm making sure that it doesn't leak. And I started now with a line on the inside of the two barriers, because I want them as smooth as possible, so that I don't have to sand if I take the geode out, so that I have a flat surface. Yeah, and this geode is about 60 by 60 centimeters. My MDF board is 60 by 60. It's almost covered, so it's a little bit smaller, but it's a large freeform geode. So, and now I'm using the Dawn dish soap to make my fingers wet, and then I take the excess of the silicone away. And if you use the Dawn dish soap, then the silicone isn't that sticky to your fingers. And then I'm with my fingers, I make the whole line smoother. And that's why I'm using the Dawn dish soap. So all the way around the silicone, I'm making it flat. And now I'm starting at the outer barrier. So on the inside, extra line of silicone. Yeah, and I made my barrier now two lines high, and yeah, if I want it higher, then it can also I can also do it later when I already started with the resin. I can always add an extra line if I want that. So again, I'm putting some Dawn dish soap on my fingers. Make it a little bit wet with water. And then I go with my fingers over the silicone to make it flat and smooth. And this I do this to prevent all the sharp edges. Yeah, and the excess I take away, and now I'm cleaning it a little bit because I have some silicone on places that I don't want. So with a paper towel, I'm cleaning the acetate sheet. I also will do that if the silicone is totally dry, I'm going to clean it again with a little bit of alcohol. So almost done with the cleaning. And then I let it dry for 24 hours. And then I will start with the first layer. At the moment I'm using some alcohol to clean it. So I'm done and I'm gonna wait for 24 hours. So we are 24 hours later and I can start with the first layer and I'm starting with some clear in some places. Yes, and the colors. The colors I'm using are red, yellow, orange and in some next layers white and black. But these are normally colors I wouldn't use. And yeah, I like to think out of the box what I already said. First I'm laying down some fire glass. That's a black color for the contrast. So in the clear I'm laying down the fire glass. Yeah, with my steering stick I'm placing the fire glass on the place I want, pushing it in the clear resin and against the silicon barrier. So I'm starting with the first color. It's a very nice red and it's a transparent one from Eli Chem, and it's a new paste they have and I'm curious how it looks. I'm going to be using all mostly transparent colors. So all the way around this nice red. All the colors I'm using are listed in this video. And also I'm going to put all the links where I buy my materials in the description box. So you can also find them there. So with my steering stick I'm going to I'm pushing the red color against the silicon barrier. Yeah, now I'm adding some glitter. I mix some cosmic shimmer glitter bits, a red, into the resin, and also some Bombay ink. So over the red I'm laying down that glitter. Now I'm using the Resitint Plus copper, so next to the glitter, all the way around. Also a very nice sparkly metallic color, and I'm pushing it against the glitter line with my steering stick, so those colors can blend into each other. I don't mind, I like that, because then it gets a bit of a natural look to it. I don't like the straight lines. Now I'm using the ruby of Just Resin, also a very nice metallic color. So all the way around, also this color, and this color can also blend into the copper. Now an orange color. Very sparkly, the orange. Next to the fire glass. And now I'm using a very bright yellow. It's also a paste of Eli Gem. And yeah, I like it. It's very bright. And in the middle I'm using the Sparkle White. And it's a powder. So those three colors, the orange, the yellow and the sparkle white, can blend into each other. Again, a glitter line. And now I'm using the red again, but then more transparent than I used on the outer barrier. That's the same color, but now I have added less red paste in it, so it gets more transparent. So I'm pushing the colors into each other. So almost done. And now I'm heating it because I want to blend the colors into each other, and also for the air bubbles. And also the torch, because you can pop the bubbles easily with a torch, so that's why I'm using it. So at the end of this video also a close-up, so if you want to see that, then you need to wait. So it's 8 hours later, and this is how it looks now. It changed a lot. The colors have blended nicely into each other, and I like it a lot for the first layer. And I'm going to get a hard time for the second layer, because I like a lot of parts, so I want to keep a lot of the first layer. But there you see the copper and the glitter lines, very nice, and the ruby of Just Resin. Little bit difficult filming in the sun, but yeah, sparkles a lot, very nice. I didn't expect this from these colors together. I never used these colors together in one painting. Very nice there, the copper with the orange, the black fire glass. Also the middle part, I like it a lot. You can see the depth in it, sparkle white, the orange and the yellow, very nice. There the glitter, and the copper again. So I want to thank you all for watching, and if you like my videos and you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. And if you have comments or questions, place them under the video, then I will get back to you. And now I'm going to think about my second layer, because I like a lot of parts of the first one. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye!